Cyberbullying.
Yeah,
oh, is it?
It's cyberbullying, isn't it?
Oh, right.
I think they're all into the sniffing them daft balloons and that now, aren't they, the kids and that.
Is that good or bad?
I don't know, I think it's a bit...
But I was thinking the other day, only all the football pitches that have gone from Failsworth since I was a kid.
Absolute joke, but there's one there.
Yeah, one on Avril Street.
Stands at Lord Sex, Umbrellas.
Yeah.
Behind Failsworth School. Mabel Rose, the only one left. Unbelievable.
Shame, innit?
Football around here, it's dead. And then they come in here and they get moaned at.
Are they still in Bucky Park, the pictures, have they gone?
Not what I'm aware of, no. But it was at Failsworth in Newton Heath, Miles Platt, it was a hub for players. And I work at an academy now and it's just an absolute nightmare because kids ain't playing street football anymore. They don't come out of the house like we did. This park, when we were what, 12, 13, 15, 16, 50, 60 kids in here on a Friday night?
Would have been, yeah. He's a. Different age groups and that.
But everyone used to look after each other, didn't they? You know what I mean? There was no bullying. There was a few fights and that. I remember a few incidents.
Well, a few used to come down from different areas, what, fancy the chances and that, but...
And they always won.
They always got done in, yeah. Well, this part's got a few stories to tell, innit, I suppose.
So who did you, like... How did you get into people... Who was the first group you mixed in coming from Mars Platt into Failsworth?
Well, I lived in Failsworth and I just spent a lot of time in Mars Platt, so I was always around here. Yeah. I was in both areas, really. But I think introduction to the park, I mean, I was brought up, as a kid I used to come in here playing football and that, but I think when I first started going out and meeting new people, new friends and that, was probably with Winner and Renshaw and that, and Edgy and Benj, Danny Clare, all them boys. Mm-hmm. You know, they was the, and then you've got Ducker, Ellis, Devo.
Yeah, all characters.
They're a little bit
older,
all characters, yeah.
Do you know what I find sad? And I'm as big a part of this, and I know we are, but when you grow up, you can bump into them people and have the same conversation on the same level as if it was yesterday when you seen them. And I miss them days. I miss them days just talking, you know.
Well, it's just prime example. That was a gate.
So it's back door now.
That was the gate, wasn't it? York Street.
Terry Stowes's and that, yeah.
York Street, innit? Spells have changed so much since I've been here since 72. And it's changed so much.
Yeah.
Can't remember half of it. Like say up round the rocks, it don't just not recognisable, is it?
Nah. There's nothing there, is there?
No.
Yeah. It is changed, but times changed, don't they? But one thing that sticks out in my mind about the reunion last year was that board. Remember us?
Mm.
And I couldn't believe the people who were on there who passed away. We didn't even know passed away. Do you know what I mean? People like Brian Amnett, Richard Kirby, who I went to school. Obviously, Burster. Vicky Bell was a massive one, but not me for six.
Yeah.
Pricer, Gary Rogers. Your generation, have you lost?
Well, Michelle the other week, wasn't it?
Yeah, Michelle the words. Just too short. But that's the thing, last year...
Simon Mack,
I know. It's unbelievable, you're not going to because you're up. But last year they do. That's what everyone got the biggest buzz off, I think. You forget your wrinkles and how old you are and what.
Yeah, but everybody's the same.
I know,
when you're there, you're all the same, aren't you? You don't look no different. You're just the same, aren't you? Do you know what I mean? You're still the same person inside. It's just your body's aged, isn't it?
But I think life gets to people if they get conditioned. They cannot go out. I know it won't affect you too, because every time I go out, I see you too. But I take it for granted sometimes, the confidence that people like us three have got. And I try and grab people, shake them up, going, come on, get out the house, you need to do something, do you know what I mean? And I don't drink, do you know what I mean? But that's what I buzz about, doing things like this, on pushing, raising money and stuff, because that was Michelle Burns' last year, of meeting people. That was I saw her in between, but the last proper conversation I had with her. And you don't know, this might be one of them.
You don't know if you're going to wake up in the morning, do you?
No, it's scary. So what other trainers have you got to do? Going on a positive note.
Say there's something. Say there's something going there.
Whatever
it's
you want.
It's
hard,
isn't it?
Whatever
life.
Your mum.
Yeah. Come on, pull some out. Blast from the past.
Police, poor babies. They're that old. The souls have come off them, but everybody will remember Wimbledon.
Yeah.
Perished.
They've seen better days, haven't they?
Yeah, brand new, never been worn them. I can get them resold.
I'm not surprised they've been worn. They've got no soul,
did they? Did have a soul on them.
What's that? Summit Rhino used to sell in there. What was it called? The other guy who used to sell trainers?
Phil Labour.
What a pair of trainers, are, kid. Now wrong, we just need a set of heels. There you go, Village Cobblers, get a set for a fiver.
See, they're iconic to me. Because, like I say, early 80s, everybody was wearing these. Yeah. They were all into the tennis.
I think, do you remember Puma, was it Bill Borg? Puma Bill Borg?
No.
Puma G. Velas?
Yeah, Puma Wimbledon.
Puma always seems to happen, fix all, didn't
they? And the Dallas. Thick.
I remember the Dave was the ones for
the about 84 then.
Yeah, the Dallas was the that's the probably the only Puma they ever bought them, the Dallas. Well, my mum bought them.
Mum's bought everything, didn't they?
Yeah, there's more of him. I think I went on to Night Quali Waffles. Remember them?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I remember when Night come out and everyone sort of Mick Harvey, didn't they? Wally Waffle, what's that? And that was probably one of the biggest brand, aren't they?
Well, they've got for silly money, don't they?
Did they? Night Wally Waffles and yellow and blue things.
Yeah. Believe me, all the people, these Night, they put the Adidas to shame for values of folks buying 600 quid a pair and all.
You're joking. Got it. Big loads. What about, what was I going to say, the trainers?
Adidas
indoors.
They were just reissued them,
weren't
they?
Yeah.
The first pair of trainers I bought after Cook. It was Puma Kenny Dalglish, just been online now.
They were black?
Yeah, black with a silver stripe.
I could have got a pair of the week.
Sure though.
Brand new in box.
Seriously?
Yeah.
But why is it people got... People... See, for me, I like it because it makes you feel and reminisce of things back in the day.
For me, it is. When we were a kid, I couldn't afford a lot. So whatever you had, you fucking looked after.
Yeah, you did, yeah.
Do you know what I mean? You don't like today. It's fucking throwaway society.
Oh, I know, yeah. My daughter's got...
And these are late 70s, and these are awesome. These are the grandson, and these are brand new in a box. A pair of Hawaii. Look at the fucking nail. How many of them?
Did they do kids' shoes like that? So leave the kids with
her? These are originals, eh?
Seriously?
Yeah.
Well, my man blagged me for years because he said you've never had them in your size, it's 5 and above.
No, honestly. I've got loads of...
So we're like 1982,
No, no, they're earlier than them, mate.
Earlier than them?
Yeah.
No way, living here.
They're 70s, then.
It's fit you now, them, Steve.
Well, they're for the grandson, vintage. But like I say, they're still brand new in a box. Do you know what I mean?
You used to get them from...
Well, all our trainers were out the catalogue when he was a kid.
Trainer shops.
Broadway Sports.
No.
Monkhouses.
Kenholt Sports.
Kenholt?
Wasn't it?
Yeah, it was chipper.
It was. In the middle that used to...
Yeah, he used to sell the snide, Sergio Tacchini bottoms.
Yeah,
the snide ones?
Yeah, the snide ones, mate.
Did
they? Yeah, they did. They went across Sergio Tacchini. He just had the two stripes on. I know, because that's where I got my game. And he used to do snide,
Farrapant. Speaking from experience.
Do you remember Farrapant?
Yeah.
I used to wear them, yeah, but I was going out in them. You probably wearing them for school.
I was school. Yeah, the Farrah
was out going out in them.
The Caribou.
Yeah, here's one. First pub you went in round there.
Back horse.
Failsworth Farms.
Back horse.
Wagon and Horses. Renowned for under 16s. Our actual headmaster, I think it's Mr. Holt, actually went in and had a word with the landlord. And we thought that's the end of it, but apparently the landlord put the word out. But the kids keep coming because no one else went in there. That's all they meant.
Well, we all went to Pleasant Arms.
Who was your lot then?
Mus, Donnelly, John Kilpatrick, Phil Ireland, Yid, Bobble,
flipping it, blast for the past. Go on, name some more blast for the past. Someone you've not seen for ages. Do you ever get back together, you lot?
Yeah, regular. Little Rushy comes out, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah, I've seen the photos.
Do you know what I mean?
Moggy and all that.
Yeah.
Budgie.
Not seen Budgie for
back house.
I've seen Scott regular.
But who were the lads who used to go to Europe all the time? Craig and Cole used to go, didn't they?
Yeah, Phil Laverer.
Phil Laverer.
Loads of them used
to go.
Did
Cooney go? Or is he blagging it?
I don't know. Like I said, it was one of them, innit? They just went straight over there. Got a load of left school. That was the first thing they did. Left school, their job was let's go over there, get a load of gear.
For me, I always remember them lads wearing the best gear. I used to look at them off, that's how I want to dress. And it's amazing, isn't it? Because they got that from Europe, brought it back to Failsworth, and then it had the effect that it's had now. And that's still with me. I still remember semi flares, Adidas trainers, Bennett's on top.
Failsworth was a big up for it all, wasn't it?
They
were one of the first people, and they all go about the Scousers, did it? Yeah, they might have done, they was on the football, there was lads coming from Failsworth from like 70s, 78, who were working over there, doing a job, a proper job, and then going, can I have a problem with this? fucking easy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then next minute, they're all on it, aren't they? Do you know what I mean? Like, say they're all older than me, two or three years older, so they were sort of the people you looked up to. Do you know what I mean?
To be fair, he does it in Grafton's, the book he mentions it done at Failsworth, if you went through Failsworth. What's he called? Colin
Goldblainer.
Yeah, he speaks about Failsworth. I remember Dave Millen used to go Europe.
Yeah, they all used to. There's a story about where they all turned up at one fucking town and it had all been cleared out. There was fucking three mobs of them. They were running in a shop to go and do it, and somebody had already been there, and they were all from round here, and all the three mobs had turned
allegedly
up. Yeah, allegedly.
There's once a tale of, I think it was a year above us at school, they went on one of these school trips, got took over to Austria, but in the shoe shops in Austria, the shoes that were on show on display was the opposite to what they were in England.
Yeah.
Someone got onto it, so he was pinching all the left trainers. Pinching all the left trainers in Austria, and then brought them over here and went robbing the right ones from town.
That makes sense, man. I always used to think my right foot was bigger than my left, but now I know them trainers that I bought off that kid was probably like 5 or 7.
Yeah.
But what else have you got there, Billy? Ultimate Hotel.
You must use the silver bullet.